Hello everyone, all who are one body of Christ. Do I say welcome to this year that's getting together? Today we're meditating upon hope and faith. Before we start, let's just talk on this topic. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. Now faith is confidence in what we hope for and assurance about what we do not see. Now, so you can learn from the verse you just read. Faith and hope have different meanings and different functions as we walk with God. Hope feels good, doesn't it? Possessing hope fills your chest with anticipation and expectation. On the other hand, when our hopes are never realized, it can feel like a death in some ways. The Bible supports that. It says hope that is put off makes one sick at heart. And faith, what does it mean when we say, I am taking a leap of faith? The answer to that question highlights the difference between hope and faith. Hope has more to do with our will, our dreams, our goals. Faith has more to do with our walk, our demeanor, our actions. Hope and faith are tied. They are difficult to separate. The Bible says, "For we through the Spirit wait for the hope of righteousness by faith." We use our faith to wait for the hope of righteousness. Another verse differentiates faith and hope this way. Now, faith is confidence in what we hope for and assurance about what we do not see. Hope requires faith for fuel. When my parents and I were told that I needed inpatient treatment for my eating disorder or I could die, the shame I felt was almost too much. I couldn't beat this thing on my own. It was controlling me. So I submitted and went because deep down there existed the tiniest flame of hope. When I released as a necessary, as my time was in treatment, there had been no magic cure. I needed to follow up with my faith, next step of hope with acts of faith. Faith that God could bring light to the darkest places in my heart. Faith that I was lovable despite my brokenness. And the often quoted scripture, we hear Jesus tell his disciples, "Your faith is too small." What I'm about to tell you is true. If you have faith as small as a mustard seed, it is enough. You can say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move. Nothing will be impossible for you. Our acts of faith carve possible pathways for God's miracles in our lives. But for once we take steps, we can't stop moving. We have to keep moving if we want to get through the other side of that mountain. This message also gives a promise today. The promise is, if you have faith like grains of mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move. And nothing will be impossible for you. Let's close this time in prayer together. Please join me in this prayer. Dear Lord, Heavenly Father, mighty, wonderful God, how I praise and thank you for your plan and for my redemption. Help me to hold lightly to the things of this world and to watch for that wonderful day when Christ will return to take us to be with himself. Thank you that I am part of the new creation in Christ. May I live and may move and have my being in him to bring you praise and glory for all the days in my life. In Jesus' holy name I pray, amen. Choose an act of faith, however small, towards something you are hopeful about. Now, go do it. How about today, one of God's going to talk to you tomorrow?